See that driver's door is wide open going down the road? Mayflower, your back door is open. Your back door and your trailer is open, dude. That's why you put a lock on your trailer, dude. In case somebody wants to get back there and look around. He doesn't even know his blinker's on. I can't get him on the radio. My radio. Mayflower, northbound. Back door and your trailer's wide open, dude, going down the freeway, boy. He's got his blinker on. The guy just passed me. I just noticed that. And door's wide open right there. And he's got the blinker on. Well, I noticed he had it on his phone. We didn't catch him. No, I can't say he's on the phone because I don't have video proof of that. You gotta take my word for it. I saw the guy pass me. He was looking at his phone. And I think it bears true that he doesn't know what's going on. It took him forever to turn his signal off. I'm gonna stay on his back door and guard him, but that's a big time ticket right there, boy. Trailer door wide open. Hard to see. Let's see if I can get him. You see that? I'm trying to get his attention. I'm trying to tell him on the radio, but I don't think he's. Northbound, your trailer door is open. Northbound. 416 rather. Your door is wide open in the back. Decent CB radio, I can tell somebody and protect them from getting a big fat ticket. Not, the radio's alright, it's just the way the antenna is. SWR, all that kind of stuff. Bad tune on my radio. Antenna, rather. Doesn't matter. Anyway, so the moral of the story is that's why you want to put a lock on your trailer. So that you know it's the doors are shut and nobody can open them. Driver has a better radio that can tell him. Let's tune in and listen. I think that's probably the second time in my career out here I've seen somebody driving around with their door open. He's also flashing him. Let's both flash him. Maybe he'll get the clue. Me and this other truck, Milan, are flashing him. I know, right? Sorry, I had to flash your mirror, but I had to do it. We're trying to get his attention, man. goes the emergency vehicle going the other way. If I have to, I'll call 911 and get, you know, because this is dangerous. The guy could drop all kinds of stuff on the freeway. What do you think? I think we're going to have to do it. He's waving all over the road. That's probably because he's looking at his phone. I have to do it, man. On I-75 northbound at mile marker 421. There's a trucker in front of me. What else you need? A trucker in front of me with their door open on their trailer. Driving down the road. Look at it. Mile marker 422 northbound on I-75. Oh, is this a highway patrol? Okay, I'm a trucker on I-75 northbound, and they're at 423 currently, northbound. There's a trucker ahead of me, a Mayflower truck, looks like a moving truck. Their door on their back trailer is open. I tried to get their attention, and they were looking at their phone as they passed me. I think they don't know their door is open, in other words, and stuff could fall out on the freeway. Dollies. I mean, That would be, that would suck to run that over, you know what I mean? It's steel or aluminum or whatever it is. If somebody ran that over unbeknownst in the dark like this, very bad deal. And I would appreciate it if somebody had called in 911 for me. Just that little truck ahead of us there. But that's why I say always put your lock on your trailer, man. In good conscience, I could never drive a trailer without a lock on it. With doors, you know, not a flatbed, but I could never do that, man. Because people could open your doors and throw things in there, or crawl in there, or throw trash in there, or throw drugs in there. I don't trust nobody, man. I know that's a double negative, but it sounds better, right? Highway patrol on duty around here that will be getting, flagging this guy down already. How many miles have we gone since I hung up the phone, dude? How long does it take to get somebody to dispatch out here? Let me see, there might be a way station coming up. Let's see how far away. Catch him at the way station for sure. 37 miles to the north, to the I-10. There's a way station at I-10 coming up at 37 miles, roughly. If they don't catch him, they'll catch him there. That's if he doesn't get a green light. He shouldn't. He looked like he was driving a Ryder truck, which is a rental truck. Probably does not have the, whatchamacallit, pre-pass, guessing. They might, if they get lucky, if I can get them on the radio. I tried to get them on the radio to save himself, to get that door shut before he gets a big fat ticket. There's another truck stop coming up in about 38 miles. That's Love's. It's on the other side of the scale. Yeah, I'm not seeing any highway patrol yet, dude. Somebody's furniture, their personal household items in a moving truck like that, you want to make sure it's locked so somebody doesn't get in there and steal everything. What if they had like a jewelry chest in there full of jewelry? Of course, you know, people who move. If I was hiring a moving company, I wouldn't put expensive stuff. I would say you can move the couch, furniture, stuff like that. You can move stuff that's not jewelry, not heirloom items. But you never know, some people just throw everything in the truck. Everybody's got a little control. State Highway Patrol. What mile mark are we at now? 430. That's about 8 miles so far. I mean, when did this whole thing start? Way back there. Probably around the 400, probably about the last 30 minutes it's been ahead of me. I gotta do, I'll have to download the stream and figure out the timeline and the mile markers. I'll make a video out of this, and you guys are my witness. Okay. 2 miles to I-10, which way is it gonna go, east or west? That's the question. If it goes east, there's nothing I can do. I won't be able to see the solution to the problem, unfortunately. I'd like to make a video story, you know, from beginning to end and conclude it. Catch him on video, so it really doesn't count. He was passing me up real slow, and there he goes. He's gonna go which way? East or west? He's going east. Well, he's going, we don't know yet. He's right here. You can see that door is wide open. See that? Let's catch up. They're going west, hopefully. Yes. See the doors open? You see that part of Peach? Dude! Doors open! I'm trying to protect him from other traffic here. Back over to the slow lane, Mayflower. I'm gonna open the door for him over here. Go ahead. There you go. He doesn't know the door is open because it's in line with the, he can't see it in the mirror, in other words. Well, it's dark too, but he doesn't know the door is open. Nobody's calling out on the radio either, the CB. My CB doesn't get out. I can receive, but I can't send on my CB. Let me try one more time. We're pretty close to it. 19.
Westbound Mayflower, you got your door open on your trailer, sir. Mayflower, trucking westbound. 295, mile marker.
It is going to go for the pass.
My radio isn't getting out very good. Can somebody else call it out? Westbound, Mayflower, your door is open on your trailer, sir.
I gotta call 911 again and tell them we changed freeways. We're going westbound now. maybe somebody else can call in. Because if I call in again, they're going to be like, you're just a little snitch. But if they get corroboration from another driver calling in, then it kind of adds up. Plus, his car might call in right there. You see that little car? They could call 911. And that would be like, the highway patrol could say, well, maybe it is, maybe it's true. I don't know. They're probably doing a background check on me right now. What's your name and number, they asked me. How many times have I called 911 in my life type thing? And it's always been legit. I wouldn't call, I don't prank 911. I just don't do that kind of thing. Rider rental truck, but it does not have a radio in it, I'm guessing. You see him up there, two trucks ahead. Trucks are covered at 72 miles an hour because he's going full speed. We're going 70 and I just can't touch him. I can't catch him. Thank you. CHP or the Florida Highway Patrol will call me back too. They are. Thank you. brought up. Just started driving, didn't walk around the equipment. Said, let me just go. Just drive off. Didn't check the equipment. Florida is a high theft state. We get messages every time we come down to Florida. It says, danger, Florida's a high theft state, this and that. Guard your equipment, let us know if you're going to take a day off down there, whatever. They're very leery. I remember back in my Swift days, I was parked down closer to Miami, and I did not have a lock on my trailer, you know, it was empty, nothing in there. And I was waiting for my next load, I was backed up at the truck stop, and this super hot chick came walking up to my door, banging on my door, hey, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, whoa. Look at this hot chick. What kind of hot chick walks up to a trucker in a truck stop? So I'm checking around, looking at her, you know, she's like, I'm like, I don't know, babe. She's asking me some stupid question. And it was, then she walked away. But it was later that I walked around my equipment and I realized my door was open. She was trying to distract me while people were trying to get in the back of my trailer. But luckily it was empty. So then nothing they could do. And then from that point on, I've always, always locked my trailer doors. Just don't want anybody throwing garbage in there. You don't want them throwing dead bodies in there or drugs. Don't want any of that drama and problems. No, no, sir. Station. I get a red light. So does that driver. both got pulled in. Okay, so see if see what we can do here. Try to get the guy's attention. Well, I'll tell them, if they don't see it, I'll tell them. I think this is the agricultural check station. Yeah. Let's see here. Oh, the door is shut. Look at that. How did it shut, dude? No, it's open. Let's see if anybody's home. The driver's door is open. See him up there? Thank you, Bob. See, there's police activity up here on the right. They may be the same waiting for him or no? Or are they pulling somebody over? We'll see. We'll get the conclusion to this story one way or the other. Scotty always gets his little story. Let's get over here. My video story. Pulled somebody over here. They're busy, so there'll be another officer that'll get this trucker. Can't outrun the radio, boy! We in hot pursuit now. But dude, we're way behind. We'll never catch up to him. I lost a little bit of a pole position when I had to stop and tell the officer that the door was open. There he goes right there, law enforcement. Told it. Didn't I tell you? He's going to get him right now. I think that's the same officer. He said he was going to get him, so I think he's going to get him. Cool. Poured it on, boy. Light him up right now. We better might as well get over. There it is. Got him. We got our man. Tried to get a hold of the driver, tried to flash high beams at him, tried to get his attention. Tried to do all kind of thing and save him from a bad, big fat ticket like that. What are you gonna do? We did what we could, we did the best we could, and the driver, you know what I mean? Now they gotta pay the price. Better them than the innocent public driving behind them. Coming up on another weigh station soon, I think. Go, party peeps. We got I don't know how long this took. I probably am going to download the stream and figure out. We might have gone 50 miles before that conclusion. I don't know. I have no idea. But we'll find out at the end. That is pretty incredible. In this day and age, in 2019, you can drive around with your door open for over an hour, close to an hour, and probably, how long was he driving before I saw him? How long has the driver been driving? And how many drivers and truckers and cars have seen that and didn't report it, and it took so long to get concluded and fixed? That's my question, rhetorical question of the day. Coming into a weigh station again. Oh, that's the other side of the road, I think. Anyway, so I'll make that into a video for probably tonight or whatever. This weekend for sure. And you guys were witness to that. You've been with me since I saw it all the way to now, and I don't know how many minutes ago that was. I have no idea. It's all the way back down on I-75 or on I-10 now. Wow, man. Pretty crazy stuff. Way station closed. Oh. See? Way station being closed would not have caught him. And the agricultural check didn't see it. The guy was busy, you know, he wasn't looking at, he was looking at the front of your truck, not the back of your truck. And I had to point it out to him, and the law enforcement saw that. Anyway, so yeah, we'll make this into a video and download it right now. Yeah, because this way station, if the station was open, they probably would have caught it. But it's closed, so he probably would still be going deep into Alabama as the next state before you don't hit the next way station until Mississippi. I believe there is not the next way station is the next two states away. Theoretically, I mean, somebody else could have called 911. Another officer may have seen it. Who knows? But the way it was going, the guy could have drove all day, all night with the door open. And he couldn't see it because it's the way it was angled. You couldn't see the door open in his mirror. I treat the stream kind of like a dash cam, except I don't have to worry about losing the footage because it goes up to the cloud. I don't know how many things I've filmed on dash cams that got lost forever because of some kind of glitch or error, or got recorded over on the little chip or whatever. And many, many things I've seen caught on camera, and then it got some kind of problem with the little SD card. So I came up with the idea to stream live my camera into use it as a dash camera that goes up to the cloud, preserved. There's no SD card to get corrupted or any problems. No, it's all up to the cloud, man. I can download it off the cloud. I got it, I own it, I have it, and I don't lose it. The footage, whatever it is. Say like an alien landing, like an alien spaceship lands in front of us and tries to zap my SD card. Whoops, you screwed up, little alien. It's up in the cloud now, boy. I got you permanent. There was a driver, two lanes going down to one with cone zone, all that, and lanes ending down to one lane. And this trucker passed me and damn near took off my hood with this trailer trying to get in front of me so bad, and I lost the footage forever. It was on my dash cam, my old dash cam, and when I tried to get it at the end of my day on my laptop, it wasn't there. The video was not there. And I was like, damn it. I wanted to get that footage up to show people how desperate these guys are to kill you and kill themselves to get in front of you. And the footage was not there. It was just, all I can do is tell you about it. But that doesn't count. It doesn't really matter if I tell you about it. It could be a BS story, it could be true. I can tell you it's true, but it don't matter not know how unless you got a video. Gotta have the video, dude. In today's day and age, you gotta have video proof of something. Eyewitness count almost doesn't count. Maybe in a court of law, under oath and all that kind of thing, and you need multiple witnesses to say the same thing. Yeah, I saw him do it too. Yeah, me too, I saw it too. Yeah, I saw it too, type thing. But a video is like, best eyewitness. Another hour up here, and I gotta get my fuel, then I gotta get a shower, and then we'll switch over to YouTube after we get going again. People are waking up. I like Twitch. I tried to run Twitch and YouTube at the same time on both phones, but the other mount I have over here for the Twitch was shaking too much yesterday. Shaking bad. People were saying, I'm gonna throw up watching the Twitch. You can't watch it. Oh, okay. Well, let me get another mount. I'll keep working at it until we find the right mount. The mounts I have, you guys are on right now, they don't sell those kind of mounts anymore, ironically. The best mounts in the world, you can't get them anymore. Stupid. I've had that mount for over 14 months. You just can't buy them anymore. They don't. I don't know why they went out of business or why. Why drive? You know, sales cause things to keep going. If people don't buy them. I'd rather buy the shaky one. Let me buy the shaky one. And then, you know, they keep making more shaky ones. Why can't they make one like this? It's so solid. Somewhere. they're getting in front of me to slow down. Oh, I see, they're getting off the road. Okay. That makes sense. Let me race out in front of you and then slow down in front of you so I can get off the next exit. Brilliant. this stream right here so I can work on editing it. Tonight, I'll probably release it on YouTube there. Maybe make a premiere out of it. It'll be Friday night special. I gotta get a shower over here and fuel and everything else. So I'm gonna take my break and you guys, we'll meet back here in a couple hours or less. Maybe not. Let's just do this one. That's a drive-thru. I'm not certain this is a spot. No. This is just the access back here. I'm going to end the stream and download it, work on it. You guys will be back here, like I said, in a little while. I got to get a shower, I got to get fuel, I got to do stuff. And we'll be back when we do come back. We'll be on YouTube, agreed? Come back on YouTube. Good morning. I'm getting ready to sign off right now. Some stuff happened earlier in the stream. I'm going to download it, make it into a video for tonight. Carl, Oaktown Eric, everybody. Who else is here? I'm going to sign out right now. Bye, guys. We'll be back.